Hi everyone, welcome back. We have another dermatologist skincare reaction video for you. Today, I have Dr. Annie Chiu. She's a board certified dermatologist in Redondo Beach. You have your own practice, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, it's called Derm Institute. And you might recognize her because she was in our controversial ingredients video.
That was a fun one,
wasn't it? It was so much fun and I really loved your answers. I have to be honest, I was like, me and Dr. Chiu, we should get together.
Wavelength.
Yeah, yeah. So this is what we're doing. We're gonna look at some skincare routines and we're gonna give you guys our opinions. All right, so today we're looking at Giselle. She is 26 years old and she says that she's got oily skin, she's got acne. She's gonna show us her whole skincare routine and then we're gonna, you know, do what we do and critique it a little bit, give her some pointers.
Nice. Yeah. Let's see if she's doing all the right things.
Yeah.
Hey guys, hi Susan. My name is Giselle, I'm 26 years old and I'm from Chicago. This is a big milestone for me to be barefaced and on camera. But here I am, this is my skin.
You have a note? I can already tell you've got, I see Dr. Chiu being like, ugh.
She can hear my wheels turning. I think she does have a little bit of acne. Uh-huh. And you can see it's in that sort of U-shaped pattern.
Yep.
Which is like the jawline around the mouth, the chin, it's a little more dominant there. Mm-hmm. To me, this is a very hormonal pattern of acne, especially at her age of 26.
Mm-hmm.
Which is really hard to deal with because it's not just classic oily skin.
Right.
You have other things you have to take into account.
It's like internal.
Yeah, exactly. So let's see how she's dealing with it because it's not easy.
Yeah, and does it make a difference at all that she's, so we reached out to her and we asked what her ethnicity is and she's Mexican.
Yeah.
Does that have anything to do with skin type at all?
Well, I think the toughest thing with her is with more ethnic skin types, you have more pigment in your skin. And she's gonna be very prone to what we call post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So every time you get an acne bump, frankly, the acne bump doesn't stay that long, it might be a week, but the brown spot that's left behind is months.
Mm-hmm.
So they almost always feel like their acne is much worse than it is. There's only a few active ones on her currently, but what she may be referring to as scarring may not be true scarring, but just pigmentation. But
right.
That's hard to fight, and I'd love to see her incorporate some ingredients, and we'll see if she does.
Mm-hmm.
That can brighten that a little bit.
Okay, sounds good.
I do live in Chicago, so during winter, I tend to be more dry. But lately I've been oily around my nose area and around my forehead right here. This has started I've noticed this within the past 2 months maybe. And then I have acne prone skin, so as you can see I have breakouts right here. This is my current breakout. I get on my cheeks, along my jawline sometimes, and also sometimes right here. I always get one right here and I think it's because of my chapstick.
You know, I wanna point something out. So. Something that I have always noticed, and then people will actually ask about this, is why do we get pimples in the same exact spot always?
Because you can have like a very hyperactive oil gland in one area, right? Certain cells are in certain parts of your body, and it may just be one that's a little bit more hyperactive and can clog more. Frankly, the vermilion border, which is what she's pointing to, sort of the edge of the lip, it's extra annoying because it's a really sensitive area when you get a pimple. And there are a cluster of sebaceous glands or oil glands in that area. She said it might be from her chapstick. I think it's probably from her chapstick.
You think it is probably from her
because
chapstick.
All that beeswax
yeah.
is like occluding in
yep.
that area.
Yep.
It probably is from her. If
and
she's using it all the time.
I get blackheads and whiteheads. I also am starting to see fine lines starting to form around my forehead and around my eyes. So those are my main areas of concerns. Let's jump into my skincare routine. So I start off by double cleansing. I use my Beauty 360 micellar water. I am looking to start using a cleansing balm. I'm just waiting to finish this up. So I'll be switching to a cleansing balm. Any recommendations are very much appreciated.
It looks like we're going into her nighttime routine first.
Okay.
A couple of things that she pointed out is that she feels like she's oily in these areas, but then she's got fine lines that she's noticing at
right.
26, which I would actually say is probably more of a dehydration issue right at
probably.
Her age.
Yeah.
And so she's starting off, looks like she does a double cleanse, but she starts with micellar water. We looked at that micellar water. The ingredients aren't actually bad.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Pretty clean one, simple.
Yeah.
Simple. And if she likes the way it feels and it takes off what she wants it to take off at night. It's not super irritating, so I'm not against it. I think that's actually a nice product for her if she likes the way it feels.
Yeah. She mentioned she wants to start using a cleansing balm. I have a feeling She watches my videos and she knows that I'm all about the cleansing. Cleansing balms. I wouldn't go for one of the like richer ones that I tend to like a lot for my dry skin for her.
Yeah.
But what do you think of the ones that are more like one of the Korean cleansing balms that are with man-made ingredients instead a little bit? Not necessarily like a mineral oil,
no,
but something that emulsifies, right?
Yeah, I think she is a combination at minimum to an oilier skinned individual. And she's struggling with breakouts. So I think putting things like mineral oil or things that are too oily with too many plant extracts, it's probably gonna be too oily for her to control. Like she'll feel like she's dry in some parts and too oily in some parts. So I think she needs to find a nice medium. I think those emulsifying cleansers are great. I know you don't love foaming cleansers, but here I would actually choose, if she wanted to stick with the CeraVe brand, like the CeraVe foaming cleanser is gentle. And even though it has a foaming surfactant component, it replaces it right back with ceramide. So it rebuilds that skin health barrier. And I love that for my acne patients because it strikes that balance of getting the excess oils off, but not stripping their skin at all.
Right, right.
So that's a nice one.
Because that's kind of the point, is like you want to get the makeup off, but you don't want to strip your skin, but you don't want to leave anything that's going to be too heavy on your skin if you've got oily skin.
Yeah.
It's a big balancing act, and that's why things get really personal with skincare routines, right?
And I think it's tough at this age because if you're, I think it's a common skincare concern to be at the beginning of, hey, I might be getting wrinkles, but I'm also still getting acne. You kind of don't know where to go with that because a lot of anti-wrinkle regimens are really heavy moisture based.
Yep.
And you're still struggling with some oily skin. That's a hard time and it's almost like transitional.
Yep.
So I do think it's harder to pick products then.
Yeah.
But there are some.
So I noticed that she was wearing lash extensions and we actually emailed her to confirm and she is wearing lash extensions. So Giselle, what I would say is I would keep the micellar water actually for your eye makeup to gently, you know how I am about this, gently remove. I would even use maybe like a Q-tip to just kind of get in there. And then maybe do something like the Benilico, and we'll leave a link in the description box so you can click on it and learn a little bit about it. But it's a really good cleansing balm. It's actually fairly affordable and I think it'll help remove all the rest of your makeup. Let's see what her second cleanse is though.
Then I use my CeraVe Hydrating Facial Cleanser. This is for normal to dry skin. I do tend to get dry skin during winter. I believe I bought this during winter. So should I be switching to the normal to oily skin during summer? That's a good question. I've actually never thought about that until now.
Totally. You should have a different skincare routine for summer versus winter. You change your clothes, you should change your skincare. That's what I think.
Yeah, especially if she's noticing it, right? If you're noticing that your skin is feeling drier suddenly, then you switch to something that's gonna be a little bit more hydrating and feel like, you know, it's working for the dry skin. But if you have oily skin, you wanna work against the oily skin.
Yeah, and my guess is in a really cold Chicago winter, that probably does work for her. But in Chicago, it's actually quite humid in the summer. So you would definitely want to change that up, I think.
Yeah.
That would make a big improvement in your skincare.
So you're saying the CeraVe foaming cleanser.
Yeah, you could just switch to the foaming cleanser in the summer and do the hydrating in the winter.
Then I use my Kylie Skin Milk Toner. I don't understand the benefits of a toner. Is it really necessary? I just know that anyone with acne-prone skin is usually advised to use a toner, so this is the one I'm currently using. I used to use the Kate Somerville one.
All right, so she's saying that she uses this milky toner, which I don't think it's a, like, terrible. You guys saw my Kylie Skin review. It, you know, I was kind of like, whatever about this. I did point out that there was fragrance in this, which I know dermatologists,
we don't love it.
Yeah, you don't love fragrance. And I'm always saying I'm a big hypocrite because I know that fragrance isn't good for your skin, but I'm kind of old school.
But it feels luxurious.
Yes.
I get it.
Yeah.
So if she loves the way it feels, I'm not ultra against this step.
Yeah.
But she asked herself, does she really need this step? What do you think? I think this is really optional for her.
I don't think she needs this product.
Yes.
Right? Like, so she's saying that she feels like people with acneic skin have to have a toner. I think what she's thinking is like when they go into like a salicylic acid kind of toner, something that's actually going to exfoliate her skin. This is more of like a, I almost want to say this is more like an essence toner.
Yeah.
This is something that's going to have, like it's going to maybe balance her pH a little bit more.
Yeah, pH balancing, or maybe make some products absorb a little bit better down the line. But I think with her, one of the stripping toners would not be ideal either because she has more combo skin. That's really for like a 16-year-old with really greasy skin. They're the ones that really, really need a toner. So I don't think it's crucial for her at all.
Then I go into my Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair Serum. I use a drop patterned on all over my face. And then as it's drying, I use my light stim red light therapy on my face, all over my face for 10 minutes. This was a gift from a friend who's studying to be an esthetician. I don't know the benefits of it, but since it was free, I use it.
All right, so she's using the Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair, which I actually get DMs from people all the time asking what I think about this product and if I use it, if I recommend it. So I know a lot of people use the Advanced Night Repair from Estee Lauder. And then she's using the light stim, the red light, the LED red light.
Yeah.
I'd like to hear your opinion about this before I like start to just go off, because I can be very opinionated. So let's hear it.
Couple things. I think that Estee Lauder product is what I call a legacy product, meaning I think people see their moms use it. It's like been passed down over years. But to be honest, when I look at the ingredients, I'm not seeing anything that jumps out at me that is like an ultra powerful antioxidant or anti-aging big pow ingredient.
Mm-hmm. When you say those ingredients, like you're saying like the vitamin C's, the retinols, the...
Yeah, B3s, anything that will improve something very specific for her skin type, I don't see that on this list. Mm-hmm. And I know she was concerned about some fine lines starting to happen. So I feel like that there may be things that would give pack a little more punch, even like a alpha hydroxy or, you know, anything. So we'll see if she adds that on later, but that's how I feel about that particular product. And then the light stems, I actually am not against. I think the home LED devices are great for people who can't get to a derm office for a procedure. I think that's really reasonable for people. Mm-hmm. She's a nice friend because that's not an inexpensive product.
No, that's definitely over $100 for sure.
Yeah, I think it's about compliance because they're so low powered when they're at home so that they can be safe. But you have to be incredibly compliant, which takes a lot of time to do that on your whole face regularly.
Yeah.
But I think it boosts collagen. And if she wants to be preventative, I actually don't have any issues with that. Let's see what else she does. Yeah.
Then I use my Kate Summer Dermal Quench Liquid Lift. It has retinol and hyaluronic acid. You shake it up and then you spray it onto your palm and pat it onto your face. I use this every other night. On the nights when I'm not using this, I use my pigment gel by PCA Skin. And this is just to combat all the hyperpigmentation I have on my cheeks from my acne, so all those red spots you guys saw earlier.
So she's using a retinol. It's the Kate Somerville. We did look at the ingredients in that. It does have hyaluronic acid, so it's another humectant. So she's getting a lot of hydration in her skin, but the retinol was really far down the list.
Yeah, so ingredient lists, you know, the lower they are on the ingredient list, the less of it. I kind of call this sprinkling the well, where you just put a little sparkle of retinol so you can claim you have retinol, but it may not have its full retinol effects. And especially she's using it every other night. This is actually the first ingredient I'm kind of amped that she's on, right? It does anti-aging to a certain degree. It's anti-acne, decreases inflammation. Retinol is a great ingredient for her.
Yeah.
She could get more regular about it or find one with it maybe higher up.
A little stronger.
A little stronger.
Yeah, and then that PCA, so there are two different pigment gels that they have. One has hydroquinone. I don't think this one though that she's using has hydroquinone. It has kojic acid and lactic acid. So she's got some alpha hydroxy acids happening. Yeah.
This one has azelaic acid, which here's the good news, is okay during pregnancy. So this would be like a safe one to use in that period of time. But if she's not, I think the hydroquinone one might give her a little more benefit as a spot treatment. I wouldn't use it all over, but definitely as a spot treatment. What do you think about this alternating every other night thing?
So I'm one of those people that preaches every other night, or like giving your skin some breaks when you're using especially a Retin A.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think it's good to point out that this is not a strong retinol she's using. So she could use it probably every night because it's not so strong.
I think so too.
Yeah.
And I think to really combat that pigment she has,
she
needs to be more consistent than every other night with the brightening gel.
Yeah, the PCA you're saying.
With the PCA, yeah.
Yeah. You think she should switch to the hydroquinone?
I think she should switch to the hydroquinone 2% one.
Yeah. Yeah. How long should she use it?
I'm a 2 month on, 1 month off. There's a process called tachyphylaxis where your skin essentially gets tolerant of an ingredient and it becomes not effective. So you do need little holidays. That ensures more safety as well. So I'm a 2 months on, 1 month off person.
And then, you know, a lot of people are like, they're really worried about hydroquinone, which is why they skip it a lot of the time.
Yeah.
I feel like when you're using it on and off like that, it's personally for me fine when I'm not pregnant. I feel the same way about like Retin-A, for instance. I feel like being on it for a little bit, then maybe moving to just a over-the-counter retinol is fine.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
You know, hydroquinone is such a controversial ingredient. I think that might have been on your controversial ingredient video as well. You know, the studies don't show that US-made products have an issue. A lot of the contaminants were found in overseas hydroquinone-containing products. two caveats here. This is a 2% hydroquinone, which is a very low strength. Prescription hydroquinone can vary between 4 to even 10%. We compound them much higher. It's not super effective, even at 2%. It helps, but it's not super potent. I feel very comfortable with her using this as an over-the-counter product.
Yeah.
And with that significant pigmentation, I think it could really help her.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I'm pro
the PCA
it for her.
Gel with the hydroquinone. Not
the PCA gel with hydroquinone, yeah.
Okay.
And hydroquinone as an ingredient. I feel if you use it with breaks and at higher strengths, you use it under physician supervision, you're totally safe doing it. I use it personally.
Yeah. So I have another question then. So if we're saying she should move up to like a stronger retinol,
mm-hmm.
should she be using the PCA gel with hydroquinone and the retinol in one nighttime routine?
That can be more irritating, but I think she could if she built up a tolerance to the retinol, so started every other night. I would use that.
A
stronger retinol. So it could even be different gel over the counter. But you could use that on the entire face because you're preventing acne and being a little bit proactive against wrinkles and fine lines.
Mm-hmm.
And then the reason I don't think it'll be too irritating together is that these pigment gels are supposed to be spot treatments.
Right.
So it's only gonna be on individual little spots. And the key is not too much of either of these products. I think I like pea size for retinols and even less for pigment gels. So I don't think you're gonna have too much of an overlap if you use it as directed.
And then I go into my eye cream. This is an Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair Eye Cream. I've never really used an eye cream religiously, but this was a freebie, so that's why I'm using it. I don't understand the point to use an eye cream when you have all these other products. So I'm on the same page as you, Susan.
Are you an anti-eye cream person?
I'm not anti-eye cream. I always say I use eye creams mostly in the daytime. If mm-hmm. I'm gonna be wearing a lot of makeup and I don't want it to get cakey and I don't want it to look bad, I think eye creams are great because then you're like double moisturizing basically.
Mm-hmm.
That's essentially what I think an eye cream is. Obviously there are eye creams that you can get that are like, they have a lot of retinol in them or hydroquinone or something like that. That I think is completely different because then maybe you're spot treating the area. She said that it's free. She got it as a freebie.
Yes.
I would caution people, just because you get something for free doesn't mean you need to use it.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that whole, like my parents used to always be like, finish the food on your plate. And it's, you know, as I've become an adult, I've realized that like finishing the food on my plate, especially at a restaurant, could make you gain a lot of weight.
Yes.
So you shouldn't necessarily finish it. You should just, you know, it's
well,
the
it's
same
not
with
customized,
like,
right? Yeah. Like they're just sampling whatever the next line is. That might not be your concern.
Yeah.
I think, does this one have caffeine in it? That's probably what she's getting out of it. She's getting some depuffing. Caffeine's a vasoconstrictive ingredient,
mm-hmm.
so it helps with a little bit of depuffing, and it makes the blood vessels a little smaller, so if she has a little bit of dark circles, it can help slightly. So she's probably getting that out of it, so I'm not against it. I think eye creams are more area-specific products. So they may have ingredients that build more elastin because you tend to lose elasticity first there.
Mm-hmm.
They may be products that are depuffing or address specifically fine lines or even like thicker because the skin around the eye is more delicate. I think that's the reason you would have an eye cream or not have mm-hmm. one.
But I'd almost say she's a 26-year-old.
Yeah, how puffy can she be, right?
Yeah, like, well, I mean, she could be experiencing some fine lines, which I didn't actually notice on Giselle, fine lines. Like, Giselle, let's talk when you're my age. And you've got real fine lines. You've got actual wrinkles around your eyes. You know, I think it's one of those things where she's about to put on a nice moisturizer.
Yep.
This has, I would call this an old lady eye cream. This is what I would call that.
I love it. Probably another legacy product. We use the term legacy
like
product
that.
To
it's
say
so,
it's,
it sounds
nicer.
Nicer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's another legacy product. I agree.
Yeah.
There are lighter eye gels and eye lotions that might address some of her concerns
uh-huh.
a little bit better.
Yeah.
And for maybe even less money
yeah.
or bigger bang. So either way.
All right. So she's going into her moisturizer.
I use my CeraVe moisturizing cream. I use this all over my face and neck. Then I spot treat with the Kate Somerville Aerodite Kate Acne Treatment.
She's got the CeraVe moisturizing cream, which I love. I have dry skin.
I love it too.
I
don't love it for her.
You don't love it for her. I was wondering.
So what do you think?
Well, you know, it's one of those things. So I do find sometimes people that have oily skin,
mm-hmm.
when they tell me they have oily skin, I tend to find that they're creating the oiliness.
Yeah, yeah.
But I do know when I talk to my friends that are dermatologists, they're like, no, that's too much for their skin. So I'd love to hear your
Well, I think because of the hormonal acne component, and I think this goes along with her winter Chicago regimen. I think this would be a little suffocating for her skin in the summertime, even spring. She might be occluding more pores if she has, because she complained about blackheads and whiteheads. And I think it's a little heavy.
Yeah.
CeraVe makes a beautiful PM lotion, which I think has very similar ingredients without a little bit of the occlusivity. I think that would do great for her.
Got it.
So it would be really in the same ballpark pricing wise.
Got it. So it's like taking it down just a notch.
Yeah.
To someone who has oily combination skin, a product like that.
And you can always spot treat with the cream on really dry days in the winter.
Like
if
the
there's
forehead.
An area. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. But if she's breaking out down here, it actually makes me a little nervous for her that she's putting that over the oily skin.
Got it.
On the T-zone.
And then she actually does spot treat. So we always talk about this. Viewers are always commenting about this. I love to put my spot treatments, especially for acne, before I put on my moisturizer.
Ah.
But I know a lot of people are like, no, put it on after your moisturizer so you don't smear it around.
Yeah, last step kind of thing.
Yeah, so what do you think about that?
It's a drying product is what, and you know, isopropyl alcohol and a little bit of the sal acid will dry out individual, some of those more juicier acne spots. So I'm not against that. I think if she wants to use it under or on top, whatever she doesn't find as irritating, it might dry up an active acne spot a little faster for her.
All right, and then let's see what her last product is in her nighttime routine.
And then finally, chapstick. So there you go. That's my nighttime skincare routine.
She finishes it off with the chapstick, so she is using it definitely at night, but I have a feeling, and this is just guessing because we don't know this from her, but I have a feeling she is a chapstick, throw it in the pocket.
Yeah, all the time. Gives a little gloss, etc.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think if she's getting that recurrent little pimple, that might be a cause. I think that there are lighter moisturizers or moisturizing glosses that you could use on the lips. Yeah, I don't think she needs to use chapstick every night.
Yeah, since she has hormonal acne, is this gonna be a significant, because I always think like, you don't think that this is all significant enough. You think she needs to still see an expert.
Yeah, I think hormonal acne is like an inside job. I call it outside job, inside job, and I think it's more of an inside job. There are medications that are specifically for hormonal acne. Now, I know not everyone has access to a dermatologist. It's not hard, easy to get in, etc. In general, I'm not seeing so far a lot of acne-driven products. The retinol we talked about was a little bit on the weaker side. This is a skincare routine for someone with more dry skin, I feel like, than more acne-prone skin. So that's my only concern. And it's a lot of steps that she's doing without having like a big bang product.
Yeah, instead of that retinol, different, right?
Yeah, different would be great. Different's now available at Dapolin over the counter in a 0.1%. It's actually pretty gentle. Mm-hmm. It used to be a prescription retinol. In the last couple years, it's gone over the counter. And it's still a very, very effective, well-studied, scientifically proven product. Has been shown to be effective for acne without being too irritating. So yeah. I think that's a nice one for people to reach for.
Yeah, if she's not feeling like she's really covering it, then go see a dermatologist.
And yeah, absolutely.
Even if it's like birth control, getting on a prescription.
Yeah, spironolactone is one of the prescriptions, and birth control would probably really benefit her and could simplify this for her.
So we just got a note. She is on birth control, and it helped her acne in the beginning, but now it's kind of come back. So her hormones have probably just...
She's like probably hit some sort of plateau, or she's continuing to change a little. Our hormone levels are forever fluctuating.
I mean, tell me about it. Yeah. Almost 40 here, and I'm like, geez.
I think that, you know, an evaluation if it's truly hormonal, consideration of some of those medications we talked about, she may really benefit from it.
Okay, let's get into her morning routine.
For my morning skincare routine, I start off by using the CeraVe Hydrating Facial Cleanser. It's so gentle that I'm okay with using it every morning.
She's using the CeraVe again.
I'm actually more okay with her using it in the morning, right? Like you haven't built up all that oil and dead skin and pollution and whatever.
Yeah.
So if you want a gentler cleanser, go with it in the morning. That's what I think.
Definitely, definitely. I think so too. All right, so we agree on that one.
And exfoliate. I exfoliate every other day in the morning. So I use the Pixi Glow Tonic Exfoliating Toner. As you can see, I'm almost out, so I just started using the Skin Script Glycolic Cleanser because I wasn't a big fan of the Glow Tonic. So I am looking for any recommendations on any glycolic acid exfoliators, whether that's the exfoliating pads, toners, or cleansers. I'm looking for any recommendations.
So I feel like the Pixi Glow Tonic, it's like a cult. It has a cult following. People love that product. And I think it's a good product when you're getting into exfoliating toners.
Yeah, it's a gentle.
Like it's a good kickstart. Like if you want to use it right before you're going to do like your makeup routine, mm-hmm, like mm-hmm. that kind of
thing. Oh yeah, makeup would go on it smoother.
Yeah, exactly.
Because of the glycolic.
Yeah, so I feel like people really like it because of that. I don't personally find it to be very strong.
Mm-hmm.
I know glycolic acid is actually one of the first ingredients on it, but I don't personally find it to be too strong of a glycolic acid, which is why maybe she doesn't love it.
Some glycolics are buffered, so I think where they are on the ingredient list can be a little bit misleading,
yes.
I think, in this case. My guess is it's a very buffered glycolic,
yeah.
So it doesn't have that acidic component, so it's not as strong. I like that she's using a chemical exfoliant, though. I think that's a smart thing for her skincare regimen versus a physical exfoliant, which I think could be too irritating on her.
Yeah.
So I like that. I like the incorporation of glycolic. She could probably go a little stronger with her skin type. I mean, if you, who have dry skin, thinks this is gentle,
yeah,
she's more combo oily. Could probably go a little stronger. Glytone is a great brand that has nice glycolics that are a little bit stronger. Even some of the philosophy, like kind of micropeel products, are really good for that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you like?
Everyone knows that I like Ren, which is actually
yeah, Ren has a good
glycol. Yeah, they have more of like an azelaic acid.
Which is more brightening too.
It's more brightening, yeah. You know, The Ordinary has a glycolic acid toner that I found to be really good.
Oh, good.
I think that she can maybe try that one.
It's, and price-wise is always so reasonable,
yeah,
with those products.
Yeah.
I might invest in a stronger glycolic, but less often, like once or twice a week, versus this integrated thing every other day, where now she has to worry if her other products are gonna interact with it. Mm-hmm. That's kind of how, like a skin ritual day.
Then I use my Kylie Skin Toner. Then I use the Ordinary Buffet, just a drop all over my face. And if I didn't do the light stem in the morning, I mean at night, I will use it in the morning, but usually I do use it at night.
I would just kick that toner. I feel like, especially, so the Buffet, if you don't know, it's basically a humectant with some peptides in it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I feel like she's getting that hydration that she needs.
Yep.
And making the other products work better.
When she's just prepping the skin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like she just needs the Buffet.
She can skip that, especially in the morning.
Yeah.
Like if she loves the feeling of a toner, do it at night. Giselle, your skincare routine is exhausting me. This is a complex routine. I think you could probably simplify it a little bit and get a little more punch out of it.
Definitely.
I also am concerned at some point when you layer this much, how much are you really getting penetration-wise?
No, right, your skin can only
handle
so much.
Yeah. I mean, this is just a lot of layering, I think.
Yeah.
Which is great. I mean, I have like a 10, 12, whatever step, but you've got to be smart about how you layer it.
Yeah, definitely. And getting
it's
the most bang for your buck.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely.
Then I've been using a vitamin C serum. I've been trying different ones. So I'm currently using the Drunk Elephant one. This is a C Firma Day Serum. It came with the Be Hydra Intensive Hydration Serum. So since they came together, I use these together. I am looking for a good vitamin C serum. So I love these, but I'm gonna try some other ones to see which are my favorite. So the next one that I will be using is the PCA Skin C and E Strength. I've already actually kind of cheated and tried this, and I think I'm more of a fan of vitamin C serums than creams, but since I already have this, I will still be using this as soon as I'm done with my Drunk Elephant one.
We're happy you're using a vitamin C. Am I answering for you?
No, they know. You guys know I love a vitamin C.
I'm like, finally, a great ingredient for her because it'll brighten her skin, be a little bit neocollagenic, meaning producing new collagen, and it'll lighten some of the brown spots. So I think this actually addresses a few of her concerns without making it too oily. So I'm pro vitamin C on her.
And then she's also using the Be Hydra, which I think plays well with it.
Okay, but is that just so similar to her Buffet?
It's
yeah.
100% almost exactly the same thing. They're basically just humectant serums,
mm-hmm,
right? So I don't think she needs both, especially because she's playing with skin that is acneic and
yeah,
she tends to get oily in that area, especially because the Drunk Elephant, in my opinion, tends to be a little bit oilier.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit of a thicker one. So I know that she's saying she likes the serum versus the cream better. And I would say the same too for her, but what do you think about that? She's the Drunk Elephant is, I think it is for a little bit more of a drier skin, in my personal opinion.
Well, a couple things, right? She said she was using that Be Hydra because it came together.
Yeah.
So we just talked about that. Don't use it just because it comes
together. Just because you got it, yeah.
I actually prefer her new one, the PCA CE Strength, I think is actually a stronger vitamin C and probably fits her skin type a little bit better.
I think I'd go with that cream one also.
Yeah. Now, she loves serums. She could do like a SkinCeuticals, the C plus AHA serum would be great for her because it's got a little alpha hydroxy and a really potent L-ascorbic, very active vitamin C form. I think that one would probably benefit her.
So you bring up a question that comes up all the time because you brought up that it has a little AHA in it,
yeah,
but it's a vitamin C. People
How could they possibly be stable together?
Yeah.
Because it's formulated that way.
Yeah.
I think if you go out and buy a glycolic, and then you go out and buy a vitamin C, you're gonna break them down as you use them together. If you professionally formulate and have proven in studies, which SkinCeuticals has, that you can keep them stabilized, and it has to do with the way they formulate it, then it's great, because then it's two steps in one.
Yep.
Which I think would be kind of clean for her, and address acne, anti-aging, pigmentation, which are her three main things, right?
Yeah.
Then I will be moving on into my Advanced Night Repair Eye Cream by Estee Lauder. And then my CeraVe moisturizing cream. And then the SPF I use is the Unseen Sunscreen Broad Spectrum SPF 40 by Supergoop. I use this every day, all the time, religiously. I reapply. And then my chapstick.
So we discussed the Advanced Night Repair Eye Cream in the morning under makeup, fine.
Probably good, yeah.
Fine. If she's using the PCA cream,
mm-hmm.
Let me hear what you think about the CeraVe in her morning routine.
Well, I thought it was too heavy at night, so I'm gonna definitely think it's too heavy in the morning.
Yeah.
I'm also concerned because I really love Supergoop as a sunscreen brand. That's a chemical-based sunscreen.
Okay.
So chemical sunscreens have to interact with certain proteins on your skin to become active, okay, to block sun.
Oh, that's, you know, I
And that is
that.
A lot of stuff you're hoping that your sunscreen is penetrating. I actually don't think she's getting as much sunscreen as she thinks.
Yeah, what?
What am I rocking the world?
My mind right now. What?
I've opened a can of worms.
Yeah, so wait, talk to me about this with chemical sunscreens. I know like people feel like they're just controversial in general,
yeah,
because they're
that's
not
a separate,
mineral.
Yeah.
That's a whole separate thing. You're talking about, this is just penetration and making it work.
Yeah, pure penetration. So layering is really a complex thing, and more layers have become more common over time. Sunscreen companies don't study their products in conjunction with layering, so no one really knows what the true answer is. But technically, there's two forms of sunscreen, physical sunscreens and chemical sunscreens. Chemical sunscreens work by interacting with certain proteins on the skin. That's why you have to apply them 30 minutes before you leave the house. Have you ever seen that on the back
of the
ingredients
list? Yeah, like 15, 30 minutes.
Yeah, so because it takes time. Physical sunscreens work immediately because they just sit on the skin and reflect light.
Right.
So not everyone thinks this, but there's a fair amount of dermatologists think it's gonna be hard for your sunscreen to penetrate, especially something as thick as CeraVe cream and all these serums before it, to interact as closely with those proteins as you think it's happening. So I'm actually a chemical sunscreen under moisturizer person.
Oh my God, you are like, I think I have to like go sleep or something. I think my mind is kind of blown right now.
Do you use it after?
I might start crying.
Do you use it after?
I'm always after.
Do you use a chemical sunscreen though?
Or
blended? I think you use blended.
I just use whatever I want to use that day. I've been obsessed with like a Shiseido,
yep,
chemical sunscreen that's,
yep,
like a tinted one. I've been using that. But I've also been doing my full skincare routine in the morning.
Yeah, and not everyone has a skincare routine like this or like you.
Yeah.
So I don't know if it's a problem for everyone.
Yeah, you're just
but
saying,
but when
if
I
you've
look at this, I'm a little bit,
skin.
Yeah, I'm like, how much is she really getting of this sunscreen? It's not that 40. I think moisturizers are barriers.
Yeah, they are. They are. That's
so
why you're
you barriering off your sunscreen. I wouldn't want to do that, do you?
My God. Could you let your moisturizer sit for a second?
Probably.
And then put on your SPF?
I don't think anyone knows. There are no studies. Probably.
Yeah.
Do people have time in the morning? I can't get out of my house.
That's true. Yeah. So then in that case, let's say she wants to continue using like a cream on her face. Like let's say it's wintertime and she's feeling drier.
Yeah.
She goes back to using CeraVe moisturizer. Mineral sunscreen then?
Yeah, I would do a mineral sunscreen. And if she worries about it being a little bit too white, she could do one of those combos with like,
yeah,
zinc oxide and avobenzone or something like that.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
yeah.
Elta 40 UV 46,
yeah,
Clear, one of a really popular one, has a little blend of both, so you get the best of both worlds.
I like it. Okay. I'm like shook. And then she puts on Dun dun dun. Chapstick. She is a chapstick all day girl. Yeah. She's carrying that chapstick with her, right? So maybe we let her have it at night since we get really dehydrated at night. I actually use something pretty occlusive at night.
Yeah, me too.
To like wake up. I liked the feeling of waking up with like my lip still has maybe some
plump and glowy.
Yeah, some balm on it or something. So yeah. I go for something more occlusive at night for sure. But maybe during the day so that she's not getting that breakout, maybe she just uses like something that's a little bit more gentle.
Yeah.
More of a hydrator.
Yeah, more of a hydrator.
You were saying like the core is the lip balms, the tinted lip balms.
The lip butters. Oh, and then butter. Actually Neutrogena makes like a Hydra Boost, which is a hyaluronic acid based little lip glosses. I think those would be cute.
Oh, I didn't know that. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. So just like changing it up during the day so it's not just all day with chapstick.
Yeah, just not repeatedly in your mm-hmm. pocket.
That's my morning skincare routine. I'm really nervous to hear what you have to say, Susan, but I'm so excited because this is exactly what I've been wanting, for someone to look at my skincare routine and just tell me what I'm doing right and what I'm doing wrong and just to give me their honest opinion. So thank you so much for doing this. I love you. Bye.
So when I reached out to a lot of the people in our private Facebook group about this is a surprise that we're bringing dermatologists onto the show to help them with their skin in general. So they're saying, they're talking to me,
yeah.
but they didn't know that there was going to be also
you
a
get
surprise.
Me attached
yes,
to it.
yes, which is even better. But Giselle, thank you so much for all of your support and for watching and everything. I think there's a lot we can do with her routine,
yeah,
right?
I think we spruce up a couple of the key ingredients, but I think your habits are amazing, your consistency uh-huh. is incredible, and those are things that you can't buy.
Yeah.
So absolutely. I think it's great.
Absolutely. So let's rearrange her skincare routines for her. So morning, we decided she can keep the CeraVe hydrating cleanser.
Yes.
In the morning.
Yes.
Okay, so we're gonna keep that cleanser. She can actually still use something like the Pixi Glow Tonic mm-hmm. on a regular daily basis, but you think maybe going a step up like on a Sunday.
Yeah, or like once a week or twice a week with something that's like a treatment, like an exfoliating treatment to help with your breakouts and some of the pigment.
So we're saying something like the Dr. Dennis Gross, the
Alpha Beta Pass?
Yeah, Alpha yeah. Beta Peel, yes. And they come in little, I think it's like a two-step.
Packets, mm-hmm. plagettes, I think they call those things.
Oh,
plagettes.
I didn't know that. So she's got that skin script. Gentle glycolic cleanser.
I think she said she wanted to switch to that possibly. And that's not a bad idea to shorten a step because then she could get her glycolic and her cleanser as her daily
right.
prep for her skin.
So if you're gonna do that, then you're kicking the CeraVe though.
Yes,
like
the CeraVe cleanser
only.
Goes out.
And you're not toning at all, except for on your like once a week
yeah.
stronger peel pad. We want you to get rid of that Kylie Skin toner. It's got fragrance in it first off,
yeah.
which isn't good for your skin. And you've got all these other products that are really good and then mm-hmm. you're throwing in something like that.
Save time, skip a step, finish what you have, but don't get another one
yeah.
if you want to save a step.
You can keep the Ordinary and the B3, the Be Hydra Serum from Drunk Elephant, but one or the other. So like use one up, then jump to the other one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right?
Yep.
What do you think? Should she finish up her Drunk Elephant C-Firma Day Serum?
I think you should finish it. I think it's a great product.
Yeah, it is. It's a good
or
product.
Or you could hold it for fall winter. And winter.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
It'll feel better.
You'll like it more in the
when
in
your
the
skin
fall.
Is dry.
Yeah.
And then instead, go with the PCA.
Skin C Strength Cream, because you already have it,
yep.
and it's a great vitamin C. Would you do it in this order? Would you do her C after her B serums?
Yeah, I personally would, just because they're more humectant.
Yeah, okay.
And this one's a little
especially
bit thicker.
Especially this property,
yeah. This one's a little bit thicker. And then that eye cream, I would just use that in the morning, right after the vitamin C,
yeah.
What do you think?
That's a great idea, and I think it'll be a nice prep for makeup and kind of de-puff. And help with your dark circles during the day.
I would kick the CeraVe.
Yeah, moisturizing cream is a little bit too much. A consideration would be getting a Super Goop moisturizing sunscreen.
Moisturizing sunscreen.
Or moisturizer with sunscreen. And that way you don't have to worry about the penetration and you're yeah. still getting both in one step.
Yes, yes. And also, people ask about, are moisturizers with SPF mm-hmm. strong enough? Like, are they effective enough? I always say they are, but the problem is people don't put enough, right?
Yeah, they're effective enough if you use enough.
Yeah.
But if you're like a little dime-sized person, it's not enough.
Yeah, and then using just like a light lip balm.
Yep. Like a tinted gloss that
yeah.
is not as occlusive during the day.
That makes sense. All right, so then let's go into her nighttime routine. So because she's got the lashes, I would use the micellar water just on like her lash area and her eye area. Mm-hmm. Then I personally would throw in the Vanilla Co. or like the Hamish cleansing balm for her because they're just more like emulsifying. They're not thick oils. What do you think?
I think so too. I think you'll feel that it breaks down some of your excess oils that you collect during the day a little bit better. Mm-hmm. I think you'll feel cleaner. Mm-hmm. And then my guess is once she feels cleaner, she won't feel the need for that toner step.
Yeah.
Which we've been trying to get rid of on her.
Yeah. Anyway. But then do you think that for her double cleanse, if she wants to double cleanse, I wouldn't consider the micellar water around the eyes as a cleanse. I would just say that that's
like a makeup remover.
Yeah, makeup remover. Could she use then the
CeraVe foaming wash? Yeah. Okay. Especially in the summer. If you want to switch it back to the hydrating, if it's very dry in the winter, I'm okay with that.
Okay. We just want you to get rid of that milk toner. I don't think you need it. She uses her light stim and she was using it right after she applied her advanced night repair. Mm-hmm. So she was partially using it
to penetrate?
Well, not to penetrate, but I think you know you don't want your skin to feel really tight and dry.
Oh, I see.
What I would use? Her Buffet.
Yes.
Or her Behydra.
Great idea. You'll get the Glide. She's looking for the Glide.
She's looking for that. We're getting rid of the night repair, right? The night repair serum for her?
Yeah, I think you finish it and then maybe invest in a product with more retinol, which will, I think, really, really improve the acne component.
Like just basically skip that serum step and move into a retinol serum step.
Exactly. You could do a retinol serum or you could do a moisturizer with retinol or you could do a retinol treatment like a Differin. But I would skip this advanced night repair serum. I just don't even think her skin is mature enough for it.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. Again, she says legacy, I say old lady. And then we want her to spot treat.
Yes.
It's just for the PCA gel.
For her brown spots.
Her brown spots only.
And the Eradicate for the active acne inflamed spots.
So does she use this before her moisturizer or after her moisturizer?
I don't care. I think they're pretty strong. She can use it like whenever she wants. You like it before, right?
I like it before because I just like my active ingredients to be. Because I think of moisturizer as
a barrier.
Yeah. So, and then we were kicking the eye cream at night. She doesn't need that one. And then CeraVe moisturizing cream.
There is a CeraVe hydrating lotion, or CeraVe PM lotion, which is great for acne combo kind of skin.
Yeah.
So just a little bit lighter.
Yeah. Okay, a little bit lighter. And then we're gonna let her have her chapstick at night.
Yeah. If you love it, keep it.
Keep it at night, just not during the day, all day. Giselle, if you have any questions, obviously ask in the comments below. I'll answer for sure. We'll have Dr. Chiu answering too. We'll be in the private Facebook group. I mean, there was so much information. I was even kind of blown away with this video, with some of this information. So,
good.
Yeah, thank you so much. And if you guys want to submit any of your skincare routines, you can find all of the information below in the description box. You can also find out where you could find Dr. Chiu. So we'll leave all of that down below and we'll talk to you guys soon.